Hey guys, I'm LB, and we are back, playing more Subject X Reconstructed. This map, the first time I tried to load it, crashed my game. So we are trying again. Time for Training Chamber 3, Rupke? Is that supposed to say Rookie? Not Rupke? This one focuses on lasers, don't get burned. Well, alright then.
Time for Chamber 3, which is one of my favorites. It contains the knowledge meant for lasers. Some even say that aperture lasers are very vintage. Enjoy this chamber and I'll get to work on updating the relaxation room. Pardon me while I change some of these info boards. They're outdated and are due for replacement. Checking on the status for the new reactor and it's still in surge. But the good news is it appears to be stable. But I can't
what is this thing?
Tell how long it'll remain.
Is this a light
like that.
Bridge?
I'll keep you posted on this.
Oh, I almost couldn't get out of there. Alright. Or is that an emancipation grill? No, I don't know what that is. Wait, the cube levitates on it, and I don't? Why is that a thing? Also, there. Couldn't get out again. Is that just supposed to be like a fancy light or something? I have no idea. Alright. On to the next. I'm not doing these at 2x speed. For, various reasons. Mainly 2x speed being a little bit too much for me right now. I have a slight headache, and I'm hungry. And I will eat after this. You really... I'm not entirely sure what you're going for with all these training chambers. I mean... like, I understand you want to do it for story reasons, but... why... like... when you're making a new community map, there's no reason to do training chambers like this. Also, I don't know if you've noticed, but Portal 2 taught players how to use laser cubes and lasers and all that without so many of these little teeny puzzles like this. I mean, this is a good idea, and this is how you would do things in a test map, but I don't really agree about doing things this way in this context. Alright, we need to... I remember this much. That's at an angle. Hopefully it'll work, though. Yeah, it works. Okay. I think this one has the pop quiz that I'm not a fan of. The guess the angle pop quiz, if I recall. Oh, we actually want it here. Is that thing supposed to tilt the cube for us? That's a nice, kind gesture. But, I can tilt the cube without that. I guess some players would need that to tilt the cube, though. It would be cool if somebody could, like, mod the game or something to allow it so that you could, tilt the cubes with, like, another command or something, but I haven't seen any custom maps do that, so I think it's either really hard, or not doable without modding the game's files before downloading the map. Let's see here. Alright then. Oh, that startled me. Okay. Yeah, like I said, there's really no need for all those. Yeah, here's the pop quiz room that everybody who I saw play this when I wasn't paying much attention took forever in this chamber. Can't do that yet. How does we want to hit that? What is that? Flip panel? Must be a flip panel. We could probably do that right now, actually. Yep, there we go. Okay, so then we do this. Oh, come on, cube. Wow, I did that just right. Okay, so now we have three cubes. What's the other thing we want to activate? The button? Let's see. Yeah, it looks like the button is the other thing we want to activate. And it also seems like we want to have this pointed through the portal somehow for some reason. Let's go ahead and just do it. You never know when having a laser pointed through a portal will be useful. Maybe it was supposed to have been for that, I don't know. Either way... Okay, maybe we do want it for that then. Okay, there's that. So, let's see, we want to hit that, so we'll just stack the cubes, right? Let's try stacking the cubes. Oops. Oh, that was weird. There we go, that is a problem with stacking the cubes when you have broken cube maps, is that you can't see through the cubes. And then we have a button. And that gets us this. I guess so that... What will we use this for? Oh. I'm assuming we have to use the laser cube glitch, cause otherwise... Well, no, that still wouldn't make sense, no, cause that's too low. I do need this door to be open, right? There's nothing that'll make this go down? Thank you. Am I being an idiot about this? No, because it's too high. I am being an idiot about this. I know what I'm doing wrong. Stop yelling at me. I know, I know. There. Now they're at the same height. Ish. There we go, much better. Hello? Well guys, as always, thank you for watching, and I really appreciate it. You can show your appreciation wait, why am I doing my outro? This is only one puzzle. Yeah, we're only 12 minutes into the episode! I got distracted by the fact that this, yeah, that distracted me, basically. So do I just stand here, or... Ah... Okay. So that chair doesn't even have to be there. Alright, next test chamber.
And another trip.
Cleaning chamber awaits. Have fun, rookie. I've included voices for the droppers. Should come in handy.
I'm guessing this is because people didn't play the introductory levels and didn't understand how to open doors. That was a weird sound. Yeah, this is new. Why do the doors make that weird squeaking sound?
Entrance save the queue. Dispensed.
That's a weird sound.
Entrance.
In case you can't tell, I'm very impatient. Why does it say that every time? Maybe that? I don't know. Are you serious right now? There you go, that's where you belong. What do we have here? Portals can pass through? Okay. And I can keep them. Cool. But I'm guessing objects can't.
Weighted cube dispense.
Oh, yes. That's exactly what this is. I don't know why they don't have more of this in the main game. Cause this makes for some really cool puzzles when you do stuff like that. Having fizzlers that only block players, or only block cubes, or only block lasers, or only block gel, or a mix thereof, you know. Alright, so, looks like we wanna have... What? Oh, like if you- okay. Like,
item dispense.
We did that. Got ourselves trapped by not being able to grab that. What? No, we can grab it. What's the purpose of that thing then? Okay, well I'm not sure what that's for. Also, there's no reason to do this. It's kinda tedious. And also, precision jumping is not good in this game. And also these cubes, they like to tilt a lot. Unless there's some other way to do this, I really do not agree with this being a puzzle. This is just tedious.
Sphere cannon dispensed.
Alright, where do we want to put the sphere cannon? That's an interesting thing.
Those sphere cannons are one of my favorite inventions in Aperture. Used to be part of our shooting gallery. But those cannons can be calibrated to 50,000 tons, which would explode the cannon itself.
Okay, interesting story. Cool story, bro.
Action, save the cube. Dispense. Your cannon. Dispense.
Where do I want to shoot this guy? Up there? Okay. Well, okay then. Oh. Is this actually where I'm looking, or is it where it seems to be? That looked like a direct hit to me. There we go.
Hang on to something.
Spear cannon. Dispense. Spear cannon. Dispense.
I almost got stuck in that hole. Let's see. Yep, yep, yep.
It seems that the reactor shakes are returning, and it seems the bar and the relaxation rooms have collapsed. But at least you are alive. That's definitely a plus.
What am I supposed to be doing here? That? Okay.
Entrance, save the cube. Dispense. Entrance, save the cube. Dispense.
Where was that entrance, save the cube, dispense? I've never understood why the spear cannon has to charge up.
Entrance, save the cube. Dispense. Spear cannon. Dispense.
Oh, come on, faceplate. Gotta help it a little bit. So, I guess I want to shoot that, right? With very precise aim, might I add. Oh, come on, game. Give me that. There we go.
Engine, save the cube. Dispense.
More crayons. Oh, good goodness. Oh, this is what he was asking me about. Yeah, so, GamerXD54 asked me about my keybinds for speeding up my, movement speed. I guess this is what he was asking me about. Why only a short time? I guess because people don't have keybinds to turn it off, why not make it a toggle? Progress saved just for walking down here and doing nothing. how to even begin. Let's just press all the buttons. Okay, where was that Edge of Safety Cube distance at? Somewhere in here? I don't even know, it's really hard to see through this grating. Progress saved again, just for walking down here and doing nothing. Is there any signage anywhere here? Oh, that signage, okay. Okay, so the colored dots are signage. Probably not very good for colorblind people. I'm not colorblind, but there are colorblind people who try to play this game. I don't actually see how to begin here. That's the steer cannon. Oh, is that... Oh. What does this do? What? Oh, I need... all of the blue to do something? Flip panel. I'm not used to the aesthetics here. Progress saved again for doing nothing. Where is there another portal surface? There's that. But I don't have any- I don't have yellow. I don't have a cube. I do not see how to proceed. Blue needs all that. What does this need? What dispenses you? Who dispenses you? The ball cannon you have- yeah, okay, but how do I get the ball cannon? I need red. Ow, where is red? Red is... no, these are orange. Progress saved for doing nothing. Progress saved for doing nothing. That is definitely red, and those down there are definitely orange. Yeah, you can see the color difference. Is that... portable? That's portable! Okay. Finally making some kind of progress! Alright, so then we can do this. And why would we want to do that? I don't actually know. What's even happening there? Why do I want to do that? Okay. That's actually not helpful at all. That's not for that. This needs a bunch of stuff, I'm assuming. Yeah, okay. Any of these... no, that needs like a bunch more stuff. Okay, well I can get over here now. Oh, that's what this was hitting. Oh... oh... progress saved for doing something. Come on. There we go. Here is my Edgeless Safety Cube. Alright. So then... that's a sphere, okay, so then we'll wanna do this. Could also do that. Come on. Sort yourself out, Cube. Get your life together. Let's head over to this one. Oh, and that turns this off. Oh, and then we need the... okay. Oh, that's... for a second there, it looked like it fell through. That freaked me out. Alright, let's do this at 1x speed. Because I am terrible at jumping. Point made. This is the only one where you would need to push stuff off of it with the pusher. The pusher button. And again, this is just tedious. There's literally no reason to do this. You could just have a door, or a laser wall, that requires two cubes, and it would be exactly the same thing. Alright. This spear cannon disintegrated itself. Okay, so now we have one down there. So we can do that, whatever that is for. Alright, back to 2x speed. No idea which cube is which anymore, don't care. Oops, come on. Progress saved for doing some stuff, I guess? I'll be honest, this doesn't feel like much of a puzzle, this just feels like walking around pushing buttons. Where did that... here it is, here's the edge of safety cube. Like, so far this hasn't really challenged me at all. I've just had to look around until I found the thing I have to do next. Whee! Alright, so, flip panel. That flip panel? Which flip panel? That flip panel. Why? Oh, cause the faceplate, right? Don't wanna go in there. Where do we want to go? I am not clear on the concept. Oh, that's why! That's an autosave point, I didn't... couldn't even tell. Where do I wanna put my other portal, though? You can go back out? what's the purpose of that? Well, gee, thanks, that is absolutely a useful hint, after learning many times how to use the bolt cannon. Shoot items out of the air, huh? What items are in the air, though? What do I want to use this for? I am clear on the concept. What? What did I just do? Did I fizzle one of my... What? What did I just do? What did I just do?
Your cannon. Descend.
The trigger that makes that voice play can be activated. Oh, wow. Okay. What exactly am I trying to do, though? I really do not have a clue. This? That's the only thing I can think of. That I haven't done yet. Wait, I thought I did do that yet, though. Oh. Well, okay then. I guess I could use this to shoot it out of the air, but why would I... Why would I do that when I could... Well, I guess this is easier, technically, than, And... I'm trapped. Oh no, I'm not. Good. Okay, so I'm a little bit too early. A little bit too low. A little bit too late. A little bit too late. What? How did that not hit? There we go! Oh my god! That had not the effect I wanted it to have. Hey, where did it go now? Went somewhere around here. Hey, we got it. Honestly, I think it would have taken less time to just bridge the gap again. And now we have to move everything. Because of course we do. So, I want to tell you something, GamerXD54. If you find that you have to add these to your maps to make them enjoyable, I think it means your maps are not designed well enough. If the player has to go back and forth a whole lot to be able to do anything in your map, it's probably not very good in terms of the design. Take this as constructive criticism. This map needs a lot of, well, work done on it. Basically, what I'm thinking... You could completely eliminate these entirely, and join them up to here so that... these four here, as well as being orange, they could also do the flip panel as well. As long as you properly convey that to the player, then they wouldn't have to move as much, and once they finally got this other guy, they could put him right here and be done with it. But, yeah, there's some other things that need... some work as well. But, for now, that's the first thing that came to my mind. Orange. What did orange do for me? Also, the whole colorblind thing might be an issue for some people. Where is orange? I don't actually remember where orange is. Did we ever even find it? Oh, that's orange. How do I get through here then? Green? What the heck is green? Where is green? Wait, this is... What? Is this a thing here? What is this?
Thank you.
No, that is definitely not a thing. Whoops. Please don't crash my game. Please don't crash my game. Please don't crash my game. What?! This is not where my last save point was! Oh, don't tell me I have to do all that again! Where's green, by the way? Oh my goodness. That was my last manual save. What happened? That save point was doing nothing that whole time? It was just making text appear that said that it saved the game and it actually didn't at all? I didn't hit F7, I just died outright. That's an issue. Oh, screw you! Where'd it go? Oh, I knocked it out of the air. It knocked me out of the air! So I knocked it out of the air. Alright, so... where did we need to use this again? I don't even remember. There's just... so much... stuff in here. I already forgot where we needed to use it. Progress saved my ass. Where the heck? Oh right, that thing. Yet another precise shot. Oh my goodness, don't make precise shots like this. Somehow that actually worked. Alright. Now we're back here, and where the heck is green? Like, I don't see how I'm supposed to disable this. Wait, what? What is that? Is that a thing? How is anybody supposed to even see that there's something there? Also, how do I get this to... yeah, how is anybody supposed to know that's a thing there? I saw it by pure chance, just looking around. Yeah, that is not well, that is not very well done, to say the least.
Great job on completing the chamber. Even though the relaxation room is gone, you must continue.
Well, at least I'm in the Hall of Fame, so that's good. Well guys, as always, thank you for watching, I really appreciate it. GamerXD54, you have some work to do. I will see you all in the next episode. Goodbye!